This video is about making instrumentation amplifiers out of op amps. In particular, about making an instrumentation amplifier using three op amps. It corresponds to section 40.1 of the Applied Analog Electronics textbook. Now remember that an instrumentation amplifier and an op amp, they're both differential amplifiers. The problem is that to use the op amp, if we use it just by itself, it has an extremely high, not very well-defined gain. And we use it always with feedback in order to set the gain to what we really want. The problem with doing that is that when we do the negative feedback, we've now only got one input that's an extremely high impedance. The negative input, even if we can use it, isn't a high impedance input anymore. If we need two high impedance inputs, which is what we want for an instrumentation amplifier, we can't use just a single op amp. The trick we use is to use one op amp for each of the inputs, and that way we can have two high impedance inputs for the two inputs of our overall amplifier. Let's take a look at how that works. So we start by saying, all right, two inputs. Let's call this one Vm for the minus one, and this one Vp for the positive one. And each of them we're going to put into an op amp. And we're going to put it into the positive input of the op amp. And we'll have the negative input in a feedback loop. And we could just make these things resistors. If we stopped there, we'd kind of be in a little bit of trouble, because this would be just a unity gain buffer. There's no other input on the negative, so that this pulls the voltage Vm. The output here would be Vm. And all right, we could do that, but we'd always end up with a gain of 1. The trick that we use in the instrumentation amplifier is to add another resistor here, R gain, that connects the two negative inputs of the op amps. And now we can actually get gain from this pair of amplifiers. Now we're still looking at two nodes here. So this amplifier, which is the first stage of the three op amp instrumentation amplifier, notice we've only used two op amps, so we've still got one to go. But this first stage here is a differential to differential amplifier. We have an input here. What we're interested in is Vp minus Vm, the differential input. We have a common mode signal, Vp plus Vm, or the average of Vp plus Vm over 2. Which is something we're trying to suppress. We want to get rid of the common mode signal and amplify just the differential signal. So the output here is also going to be a differential signal. We're going to be interested in Vb minus Va. And it'll also have a common mode, Vb plus Va over 2. And so our first task is going to be to figure out what are those signals. What is VA? What's VA? What's VB? What's the sum? What's the common mode? Or what's the difference and what's the common mode? So let's see how we can figure out what this is. First thing is to look at sort of first principles on op amps. This is a negative feedback loop, so the value of this, the voltage here, is going to be Vm. It's going to be echoing what's on the positive one here. And the value here is going to be Vp, echoing what's on the positive input for that op amp. So we can figure out the formulas here, because we've just got a voltage divider here where Vm is the weighted average of Va and Vp, and Vp is the weighted average of Vm and Vb. So we can just write that down. Vm is Va times R gain plus Vp times R over R gain plus R. And VP on the bottom is VB times R gain plus VM times R over R gain plus R. All right. That's not quite in the form we want, because here we're talking about what's VM and VP, but we wanted VA and VB. So we can rearrange this a little bit. Multiply both sides by R gain plus R and get VM times R gain plus R equals VA R gain plus VPR, and VP times R gain plus R is VB R gain plus VM R. Almost there. We can take the VM and the VP R's over to the other side and divide by R gain. And that'll give us VA is VM times R gain plus R minus VPR over R gain. And VB is VP times R gain plus R minus VMR over R gain. All right, this looks kind of messy, but things simplify a lot when we look at the sum and the difference. What happens when we look at the sum? VA plus VB. Well, everything's going to be over R gain. We're going to have the minus VPR and the plus VPR here. Those are going to cancel. And the VMR and the minus VMR are going to cancel. So we'll be left with VM times R gain over R gain and VP times R gain over R gain, or just VP plus VM. And what that's saying is that the common mode of our output signals here, which was a differential signal again, VA plus VB over 2 is going to be VP plus VM over 2. The common mode has not changed at all. We've done no amplification of the common mode. We haven't suppressed it. We haven't gotten rid of it. But we haven't made it any bigger. Let's look at VB minus VA, the differential signal that's the meaningful part, the information-bearing part of the output. Okay, so here, when we try and do the VP, it doesn't cancel anymore. You have VPR and VPR here, they add now. So we're going to get VP times R gain plus 2R over R gain. And we look at what happens with the VM, it's going to be doing the same thing. So it's going to also have R gain plus 2 over R gain. So let's just write this thing instead of this VP. Let's write that as VP minus VM. Okay, so our differential input signal gets converted to our differential output signal, but there's a multiplier here. There's a gain term. And in fact, if we make R gain small, we can make this gain quite large. If we make R gain huge, then eventually this asymptotically becomes 1. And remember, that's what we would have gotten if we had not had an R gain resistor at all, if we just had an infinite gain, infinite resistor for R gain. The gain would have been 2 unity gain buffers. VB would have been the same thing as VP, and VA would have been the same thing as VM. We would have had a gain of 1. So this is consistent with what would happen if we had a very large R gain. If we short these two things together, we end up with an infinite gain, which, of course, is not really possible with real op-amps. They have a large but finite actual gain. But this whole thing works pretty well to convert a differential signal to a differential signal with amplification. That's not our whole job on an instrumentation amplifier, though. We wanted to create a single-ended signal out of the double-ended signal. So let's go back to the design we had before. We've now got something here where we've got gain at this stage, but still have the common mode signal that we want to get rid of. We want to go to a single-ended output that's centered at VREF. All right. That's actually fairly simple to do. What we're going to do is just put in four resistors. Well, not just four resistors, four resistors and an op amp. And we will hook up the output of the op amp to give us negative feedback, and we'll hook up the positive side here to go to VREF. Now, these resistors don't have to all be the same size, but they usually are. So let's just call them all R2. All right. What does this thing do? Well, these two points, here and here, are going to have the same voltage. That's a negative feedback op amp. I forgot to label this one. V out. All right, so these two points are going to be the same. So we can just use the voltage divider formula to figure out what those are. And since this thing is a voltage divider with two identical resistors, we're basically, the point here is just going to be the average of these two points. The point here, where it's positive input, is just going to be the average of these two points. So what we've got is that VA plus V out over 2 is equal to VB plus VREF over 2. And we can simplify that to be V out minus VREF equals VB minus VA. What the second stage does is convert that differential signal here, which had a common mode signal in it that we didn't want, into a Vout signal that is centered at VREF. So when VB is equal to VA, we get just VREF for Vout. Getting rid of the common mode and converting it into a single-ended signal. So this is a fairly standard differential to single-ended unit here, where you have four identical resistors. You can, in fact, get gain in this second stage by making these two resistors the same but larger than these two resistors. Then you can get a weighted average of Vout and VA being equal to the weighted average of VREF and VB, and that weighting can come in as a gain term. But quite commonly it's done as a stage here, which does not provide any gain, with all the gain coming from the first stage. But that's something that is optional. You can, in fact, redesign this thing to make gain in both the first stage and the second stage. So that's really all there is to the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier. We have high impedance on both inputs. We have a gain stage where the gain is controlled primarily here by this resistor, R gain. And then we have a differential to single-ended conversion that gets us our single-ended output. Now, important things to notice, VREF here is an input to this whole system, and current is needed from this input. There's can be current flowing through this resistor here. And that means we can't just have a pair of resistors or something out here to set the reference voltage. We need to have something that can provide current. So usually VREF here will have to be coming from a unity gain buffer or some other current source. Vout is the only output. VP and VM are very high impedance. They don't need any current. VREF is low impedance, does need current. Doesn't need a lot of current because R2 is not a tiny resistor, but it still does need to have current, and you have to make sure you can provide that. When this thing is built as a chip, generally everything is on the chip except our gain. The our gain is usually provided externally by the user in order to control the gain of the instrumentation amplifier. If you have a fixed gain instrumentation amplifier, even our gain may be built into the integrated circuit. The reason for doing integrated circuits rather than building this stuff all yourself, couplefold. One thing is that wiring is really what costs money these days. Wires, solder joints, those things take up space on the board. Transistors are free. It's all wires that you pay for. So by putting everything onto a single integrated circuit, you have less wiring to do. The whole thing is cheaper to manufacture. But the integrated circuit chips themselves are not that cheap. So op amps begin to look attractive when you're trying to really save money and you have spare board area. The problem is that matching these resistors is very important in order for this formula to work. If they're slightly different, then you get slight mismatches and you don't get rid of all the common mode signal. Same thing here. If these two resistors aren't exactly matched, then you get slightly different, slight errors being built up, and the differential signal here won't be amplified exactly correctly. The common mode signal won't be completely eliminated. Things get really messed up if your resistors are not very carefully matched. Now, it costs a lot of money to carefully match resistors if you're putting in individual ones. What happens when people manufacture instrumentation amplifiers in single chips is that there's a stage in the manufacture where these resistance values are carefully adjusted with laser trimming so that the circuit is set to work correctly by tweaking the resistor values very precisely, more precisely than you can usually do with external resistors. So there is a value to the instrumentation amplifier all on a single chip, even if it costs more than doing the same thing with op amps and discrete resistors. But when you're being cheap, which sometimes we are, you can build this thing and get an adequate, though not as good as commercial instrumentation amplifier on a chip, you can get an adequate amplifier by doing this. And we'll look at that more in the EKG lab. We have one more instrumentation amplifier design to look at before we get to that lab, though. This has been a 3-op-amp instrumentation amplifier, and for the EKG lab, you'll find you don't have very many amplifiers to work with because the board we're going to be using for that only has room for one quad op amp chip. So if you need two stages, like an instrumentation amplifier and another stage, and you needed a unity gain buffer for VREF, if you did it with this one, you would need 5 op amps, and you've only got 4 on the board. So in a subsequent video, we'll look at a 2-op-amp instrumentation amplifier. But for now, that's all you need to know about the 3-op-amp instrumentation amplifier.